الحمد لله رب العالمين حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه يا ربي لك الحمد يا ربي لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك يا ربي لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد إذا رضيت ولك الحمد بعد الرضا ولك الحمد أبدا أبدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا رب صل على النبي عدد الخلائق حصرها لا يحسب رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين. Dear brothers and sisters, we spoke in the past about the concept of rizq and stated that it's not confined to material provision and it's broader than just money. It touches every aspect of our lives. Today we speak about another great blessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides us, the jinn and animals with, but many of us are unaware of. Or we know of it, but we forget about it. Today we speak about security. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has classified security as a magnificent blessing and extended it as a favor to His creation, without which there would be no stability, nor rest, nor happiness. That's why societies invest everything that they have in pursuit of security, knowing very well that it's the priority of every civilization. The fearful does not enjoy food, nor clothes, or homes without security and tranquility provided for him. That's why food and security are mentioned in contrast with one another when Allah presented His favors and bounties to Quraysh. He said, فَلِيَعْبُدُوا رَبَّ هَذَا الْبَيْتِ. Then let them worship the Lord of this house. الَّذِي أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ. Who has fed them from hunger and made them safe from fear. The Quran speaks to us about many concepts of security and mentions a number of its manifestations. The security of the area in which you live is a blessing from Allah. Allah also conferred His favor upon Quraysh when He said, وَإِذْ جَعَلْنَا الْبَيْتَ مَثَابَةً لِلنَّاسِ وَأَمْنًا. And when we made the house a place of return for the people and security. This favor of security of Mecca continues until the Day of Judgment. In that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made it a sanctuary for the believers, a sanctuary for their lives, a sanctuary for their wealth. This is a special security, of course, and one which the believer only experiences. Allah says, وَمَنْ دَخَلَهُ كَانَ آمِنًا. And whoever enters it, Mecca, shall be safe. This is a specific example, of course. But what's intended is the general principle that Allah alone grants us safety and security in our homes. Without security, we're unable to live. We're unable to even sleep if we feel unsafe. Allah tells us how He sent down tranquility on the Muslims before Badr. He sent down upon them amanah. And amanah is from the same root as amn, which is security. He sent down upon them tranquility so that they may sleep and rejuvenate themselves before meeting Quraysh the next day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, ثُمَّ أَنزَلَ عَلَيْكُم مِّن بَعْدِ الْغَمِّ أَمَنَةً نُعَاسًا يَغْشَى طَائِفَةً مِّنْكُمْ. Then after distress, He sent down upon you security in the form of drowsiness, overcoming a faction of you. Financial security is also a great blessing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala confers on His creation, and many of us enjoy. It doesn't necessarily mean that we have to have thousands of pounds in our bank accounts. Listen to this great hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, مَنْ أَصْبَحَ مِنْكُمْ آمِنًا فِي سِرْبِهِ مُعَافًا فِي جَسَدِهِ عِنْدَهُ قُوتُ يَوْمِهِ فَكَأَنَّمَا حِيزَتْ لَهُ الدُّنْيَا. Whoever among you wakes up secure in his property, healthy in his body, and he has food for the day, it's as if he were given the entire world. These three which are the main forms of provision from Allah: health in your body, security where you live, and the sustenance which you consume. These are the great arzaq, these are the greatest of provisions that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides. And having food for one day and one day alone is the most basic level of security. Not feeling secure unless your cupboards and pantries and fridges and freezers are bursting with food is actually a sign of weak tawakkul, dear brothers and sisters. Weak reliance on Allah. Yes, of course, there is an increasing rate of food poverty experienced by people today in society. We are commanded to look at what we have and not to look at those who are better off than us, rather to compare ourselves to those less fortunate. And in doing so, we cultivate a sense of satisfaction and contentment. Today, more than ever before, people are worried about their financial security. How will we find work in the current climate? How will we do trade and do business, people ask. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, or He makes an association between work and job opportunities and provision with the security that you enjoy where you live. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says again, reminding Quraysh of the great blessings that they enjoyed. أَوَلَمْ نُمَكِّنْ لَهُمْ حَرَمًا آمِنًا يُجْبَى إِلَيْهِ ثَمَرَاتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ رِزْقًا مِنْ لَدُنَّا وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Have we not established for them a safe sanctuary to which are brought the fruits of all things as provision from us, but most of them do not know. Due to the safety of Mecca, traders came from far and wide, feeling safe to buy and sell. The security of the city resulted in their financial prosperity. Similarly, do we not enjoy a level of security here, which many around the world envy us for? Do we not have opportunities to set up businesses without fear of gangsters extorting money from us, for example? Do we not live in a country where investors flock from across the globe due to the security guaranteed to their wealth? Therefore, there's much to be grateful about. Unfortunately, many of us have developed a sense of entitlement. We always feel that we're owed more, that we deserve more. But if we stopped comparing ourselves to those more well off than us and looked at those less fortunate, then we'll foster within ourselves a sense of gratitude to Allah. But if we continue with this ingratitude with Allah, then Allah takes away the blessing, either as a punishment, and we seek refuge in Allah from that, or as a reminder to what we enjoyed but we were not thankful for. Allah Ta'ala, He tells us, He gives us an example of a people who were given everything but they were not grateful, and they did not attribute the blessing to Allah. So Allah stripped the blessing from them and made them taste adversity so that they may return. وَضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا قَرْيَةً كَانَتْ آمِنَةً مُطْمَئِنَّةً يَأْتِيهَا رِزْقُهَا رَغَدًا مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ فَكَفَرَتْ بِأَنْعُمِ اللَّهِ فَأَذَاقَهَا اللَّهُ لِبَاسَ الْجُوعِ وَالْخَوْفِ بِمَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. And Allah presents an example, a city which was safe and secure, its provision coming to it in abundance from every location, from everywhere it does trade, but it denied the favors of Allah. So Allah made it taste the envelopment of hunger and fear for what they had been doing. When we forget the blessings and the one who bestowed these blessings upon us, Allah strips us of them. And we experience the opposite so that we may remember. We experience hunger and fear, and we seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from hunger and fear. So brothers and sisters, recognize the blessings you enjoy and thank Allah Ta'ala for them. For gratitude is a cause and a means for increasing the blessing. As Allah said, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. And remember when your Lord proclaimed, if you are grateful, I will surely increase you. But if you deny, indeed my punishment is severe. When we think of security, brothers and sisters, we often make material associations with it. Food and drink, money, homes, clothes. But there is a special form of security in this life, and most importantly in the hereafter, reserved only for the believer. The first is inner security, inner peace, rest, solace. calm of the calmness and stillness of the heart. Allah says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَتَطْمَئِنُّ قُلُوبُهُمْ بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ. Those who have believed and whose hearts found peace in the remembrance of Allah, unquestionably, by the remembrance of Allah, do the hearts find peace. The believer does not rid himself of fear, nor does his heart find rest, nor does he experience tranquility, except by the remembrance of Allah. This security is what the righteous predecessors were referring to when they said, if the kings and the sons of the kings knew what we experience, they would fight us for it. And that's because the tyrants, they may have fortunes and treasures, fortresses and castles, but they'll never possess inner wealth which is the only wealth that can bring us calm and serenity. The second security, dear brothers and sisters, is security on the Day of Judgment. A day of horrors and terror, fright and trepidation. A day when men will run away from their brothers, from their fathers and their mothers, wives and children, and tribes who used to embrace them. Everyone will say, nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself. Everyone will look for safety and sanctuary. Those who had presented good deeds in preparation for this moment will be secured. Allah Ta'ala, He tells us, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبَعَدُونَ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا وَهُمْ فِي مَا اشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ لَا يَحْزُنُهُمُ الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. Indeed, those for whom the best reward has proceeded from us, they are from it, meaning the fire, far removed. They will not hear its sound while they are in that which their souls desire, abiding eternally. They will not be grieved by the greatest terror. And the angels will meet them, saying to them, that is your day which you had been promised. And so, brothers and sisters, Allah guarantees security for a select group, for His righteous servants. So whatever you're experiencing, observe patience. For the believer is unlike the disbeliever. They are not equal. They are not equal in this life, nor are they equal in the hereafter. Allah Ta'ala, He says, فَأَيُّ الْفَرِيقَيْنِ أَحَقُّ بِالْأَمْنِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. So which of the two parties has more right to security, if you should know? Well, they are, as Allah then continues and says, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمٍ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنُ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Those who believed and did not mix their belief with injustice, those will have security and they are rightly guided. In this life, my dear brothers and sisters, there is no continuous perpetual fear. The fearful receive respite, and their condition changes eventually. War doesn't last forever. Famine doesn't last forever. But let us know that absolute security is not attainable in this life either. Just as there is no absolute state of fear, there is no absolute state of security. Absolute security is promised by Allah to His righteous servants. He says, "Udkhuluha bisalamin aminin." It will be said to the believers upon entry into paradise, enter it in peace and safe. He who fears Allah in this world, Allah will secure him on the Day of Judgment. And he who feels secure from Allah in this world, Allah will terrify on the Day of Judgment. And we seek refuge in Allah from that. We're warned to not feel safe from Allah, to not assume salvation, to not assume that we will repent before death and be absolved of all of our sins. Why? Because it implies a belief that we are in control and that Allah is merely a spectator. Allah Ta'ala, He tells us, أَفَأَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَىٰ أَن يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا بَيَاتًا وَهُمْ نَائِمُونَ أَوَأَمِنَ أَهْلُ الْقُرَىٰ أَن يَأْتِيَهُمْ بَأْسُنَا ضُحًا وَهُمْ يَلْعَبُونَ أَفَأَمِنُوا مَكْرَ اللَّهِ فَلَا يَأْمَنُ مَكْرَ اللَّهِ إِلَّا الْقَوْمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. Then did the people of the cities feel secure from our punishment coming to them at night? while they were asleep? Or did the people of the cities feel secure from our punishment coming to them in the morning while they were at play? Then did they feel secure from the plan of Allah? But no one feels secure from the plan of Allah except the losing people. Dear brothers and sisters, security is not afforded to us except by Allah. So let us earn it and recognize He who has bestowed it and not be deluded by it and know that at any moment we can be deprived and denied. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.